outbreak alert, huge health crisis we warned about last week just got much worse, spreading fast. This is the worst outbreak that we've seen in at least 50 years. 143 people have succumbed to the disease and nearly 2,000 people have been infected with a deadly airborne strain of the medieval disease that used to haunt people ages ago. Now it's back and more frightening than ever. One breath and you could be gone in 24 hours. The wrong sneeze or a seething mouth breather spits in your face and that could be all she wrote. The plague is happening in Madagascar now and let's hope the professionals clean it up before it reaches mainland Africa and other countries. 9 countries have been put on high alert according to Daily Star and some people worry about this turning into a legitimate outbreak beyond Madagascar. The airborne pneumonic plague can be spread by coughing, sneezing and spitting. It can kill in just 24 hours and is very different from the bubonic plague, which triggered the medieval outbreak known as the Black Death. The World Health Organization, WHO, has said the current outbreak has lasted for 6 months. Professor Paul Hunter gives us a quick breakdown of what could be the worst-case scenario if the plague escapes Madagascar and reaches Africa. If the plague reaches Africa and travels around the uncivilized locations, then it's no telling what could happen. Imagine trying to fight the plague while lions are chasing you. Not fun, right? Emergency disease outbreak expert Professor Paul Hunter revealed fears the plague could reach Africa. He told Mail Online, "The big anxiety is it could spread to mainland Africa. It's not probable, but certainly possible, that might then be difficult to control. If we don't carry on doing stuff here, at one point something will happen and it will get out of hand control cause huge devastation all around the world." Previously, another health expert Professor Jimmy Whitworth described the current outbreak as the worst in 50 years or more. 1918 marked the last major outbreak of the H1N1 flu which killed a reported 5,100 million people. That is about 3% of the entire population of the planet. Extreme leftists would probably say Trump caused that, which would be very interesting because he would probably be over 100 years old if that were the case. I can't imagine how cool his hair would be if he was over 100. Daily Star reports that some people fear the plague outbreak in Madagascar could last beyond their rainy season, which would give them at least another 5 months of fighting the disease, potentially all the way to April of next year. Madagascar locals allegedly blame the village people, for doing their weird ritual called Famudaana. It's a ritual where they dig up their ancestors. It's quite disturbing. Wikipedia says Famudaana is a funerary tradition of the Malagasy people in Madagascar. Known as the turning of the bones, people bring forth the bodies of their ancestors from the family crypts and rewrap them in fresh cloth, then dance with the corpses around the tomb to live music. There's only one thing I can say about that and it's a facial expression. So they dig up people from decades ago, dance around with a rotten body, and play live music? Sounds fun, sign me up. I've always wanted to do that. Dash said no one ever. This is what happens when it seems like people don't have modern technology. Do they have smartphones in Madagascar? Because I don't think they do. There's no way they'd be digging up ancestors if they knew about Candy Crush and certain websites that we won't mention here. Back in our day, before cell phones turned us into zombies with 90-degree necks, we would ride bikes and eat turkey for Thanksgiving. These villagers are digging up bones and having a party with them. That's twisted. If the plague spreads, then we better hope Africa gets it under control. If we think The Walking Dead is cool on Sunday nights, then we won't think it's cool when it's knocking on our door courtesy of Africa. Trump should ban all travel to and from Madagascar until their plague is eradicated. There's no point to allow travel to or from there for fun or business. Handle their business, destroy the plague, then open travel. Let's hope this stays in Madagascar and gets taken care of. For more information, the WHO website says the following about the plague. Plague is an infectious disease caused by the bacteria Yersinia pestis, a zoonotic bacteria, usually found in small mammals and their fleas. It is transmitted between animals through fleas. Humans can be infected through the bite of infected vector fleas. Unprotected contact with infectious bodily fluids or contaminated materials. The inhalation of respiratory droplets, small particles from a patient with pneumonic plague. This is definitely something that seriously needs to be taken care of.